Flashback, brought to you by West Side Story Newspaper, the Soul of the Empire, and the Improved Association, Questing for Solutions, also brought to you by Covered California. Now, there's been a lot of news about healthcare lately. Here's more. It's open enrollment. Covered California is here to help find a health plan that's right for you. Visit coveredcalifornia.com today. I'm Wallace Allen, your host. We'll be back right after this short break.
One, two, three, four.
Get on up, get up, get on up, get up, get on up. Publish your legal notice in West Side Story Newspaper. For the best service and the best rates, call 909-384-8131. Publishing legal notices in the city and county of San Bernardino since 1990. West Side Story provides friendly expert service. Call 909-384-8131 to benefit from budget-friendly rates. Whether a fictitious business name, a name change, a divorce summons, or any other legal or public notice, call West Side Story Newspaper, 909-384-8131. 909-384-8131. That's 909-384-8131.
I'm young, active, and in the best shape of my life. But I still know life can change in an instant. And when it does, I want to be prepared. That's why I have a healthcare plan through Covered California, to cover life's unexpected moments. And having a plan that includes preventive care just makes sense. That means I don't pay extra for services like annual checkups, flu shots, and diabetes screenings. I like that.
Covered California. It's more than just healthcare. It's life care. Visit coveredca.com to enroll or find free expert help. Enroll by December 15th.
You give me fever and a cold sweat. The way I like it is the way it is.
And I like it like that.
I got mine.
All right, you got yours. Wait a minute now, everybody got to get it. Whoa, we started. This is Empire Talks. Back, I'm Wallace Allen, here on the case for truth, justice, with the right information to help improve the situation. You know, last week I was talking to you about my wife having had her knee replacement. And, you know, things get pretty rough during that kind of recovery and all, and you know, I had suggested laughingly last week, you know, that things got kind of rough over the night and that I thought about collecting insurance. And boy, did I get some phone calls about that, mostly from insurance people and letting me joking again, guys. Listen, I do want to say that my wife is doing wonderfully. She has taken an attitude of a true warrior. She steps up. She's doing her walkthrough. She's doing all of her exercises. And more importantly, she's putting up with my crazy behind. So I really want to salute her for that. And I didn't think that we would have any reason to come up with good news after a knee replacement. But my wife is former employee of the state of California correction system. And apparently when you work with those guys, you make some pretty lifelong friendships. And one of those lifelong friends of my wife, Mr. Andre Cole, came yesterday. And I'm telling you guys this because I'm inviting a few of you over to witness the fruits of his labor. He came by yesterday with enough food. I mean, it's a party. The guy barbecued us all. Andre, thank you very much. I want to salute you for your great cooking. I couldn't salute you all the way yesterday for the cooking because I hadn't eaten everything, but having tasted just about everything, man, you are the man. I do appreciate that very much. And I also appreciate the fact that my wife did enough service and help for people while she was working prior to her retirement that people like Andre really appreciate her, and just gives me another level of appreciation for folks at the state of California sharing your good thoughts with each other and remembering to help. I appreciate that, and I'm sure you guys appreciate it much more than I do. Now, having talked about what I appreciate, I do want to bring up one of the things I'm not sure if I appreciate, and that's the tax plan. Taxes. I mean, I'm a business person as well as a poor resident. You know, I'm in business, but the reason I'm in business is to, our kids are out of school now. We've done all of that part. I don't know. Maybe it's time to retire. But the point is that there's a tax situation that appears to be attacking poor people. That doesn't make sense to me. Ms. Tammy, how are you this morning?
I'm doing fabulous.
Well, you look fabulous. You got your...
Turn on a mic,
yes. Fred, or whatever.
You're talking about taxes.
Taxes, right. Now, you're a business person. You're over a chamber of commerce.
Yeah.
What are your people saying about taxes and tax plans? And are they anxious to pay more taxes? Well, you know what it sounds like. It's a good thing.
I think businesses are looking at the bottom line of trying to reduce tax. So, you know, the more write-offs, the more things that they... You know, they can reduce that adjustable income tax from their business. I mean, income from their business is what lowers the tax. So that's what they're after. But haven't heard too much upset yet, but that doesn't mean that it's not coming.
Mm-hmm.
So,
well, our universities seem to be upset about it. Mm-hmm. I don't understand the whole tax plan, but then again, I don't understand a lot of things that the government does, and I expect most people don't. But I do know that there seems to be an attitude of, I got mine, and if you don't have yours, it's too doggone bad. Mm. I've read a story this morning about kids who are making their wish to Santa Claus,
mm-hmm.
and they're wishing for what? Guess what? You think they're wishing for new cars and flashy clothes and all the new electronics? Asking for food. There's kids in this country asking for food. So we need to lighten up, folks, on our quest to get super rich, on our quest to have it all, and realize what happens when people are left out. I mean, what do you think of a person sitting at a big banquet, right? You know, and the only people at the banquet eating are a couple of people, and everybody else is standing around watching. How long is that going to last?
Mm.
Well, with us, unless they're vegans and all the food is
okay,
meat.
Here
now,
we go
if all they're serving is meat, maybe the vegans would say, well, okay, I'll just sit around and wait till y'all starch up and don't be able to move or something. But in general, we're supposed to be, I think, kind and looking out for each other. And
well, when you say around the table, because, see, I can address these going into your taxes. Because,
okay,
see,
please.
If we're raising taxes because we've been bamboozled to think that, you know, the water this, the electric this, we need to tax on the roads
the
and
highway,
things like that.
Yeah, yeah.
Highways. Now, if we stop cutting down the trees, okay, number one, stop cutting down the trees.
Start growing more trees.
And then start growing more trees. It's because when we cut down the trees, we start moving those animals in, and we start moving that agriculture business goes up. And they're the ones that's utilizing most of the money that we're paying a lot of the taxes for. It's a big circle, Wallace. So if you think about it, you know, they keep saying, you got to pay more, but then all of our meat eaters, we want more meat. So in order to get more meat, you're going to have to get more land because you're going to have to get more agriculture.
Okay, so we're talking about how much it takes to feed cattle.
Exactly.
It talks about how much.
And the water.
Because the cattle are all enclosed, how they tend to pollute a specific area.
You got it.
You know what? Mm. I understand and heard a very good story earlier this week talking about that in specific, where people were complaining that the cattle and the assemblage of the cattle are the ones who are causing all of this pollution. Well, it seems, and if we remember, that there were buffalo herds that dwarf the number of cattle that we have in the United States now. And the air pollution caused by the buffalo herds and all of their excretions and things, there's nothing like now.
No.
No. I mean, so the point that we're, you know, if we want to blame the cattle, I don't know if we need to blame the cattle so much as the way the people deal with cattle. We keep them enclosed. They don't run around. They don't have the exercise. But once again, what we're saying is that things can stand inspection.
Mm-hmm.
We need to be inspecting what's going on with us. Now, you during these holidays, and I we had to postpone a TV production
it's
this
okay.
week because I was busy doing stuff. But on that production, you were going to be talking about how people can enjoy their vegan food during the holidays.
Yes.
I think before the end of the program today, we may want to talk a little bit about that.
Yes.
Unidentified flying objects.
Oh.
Now, you know, we've talked about these things, and folks speculate about them. And so you've got that look. What do you think about unidentified flying objects?
Is there anything out there that the government really don't know that's out there?
They're telling us about. Okay.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Is it unidentified to us or to them? When they can look and see what we're doing right now, they can read what's on your piece of paper right now.
Even though I'm inside of a
building? Even though you're inside of here.
Ooh, tell me, are you a conspiracy person? They can read this paper that I have on this desk. Mm-hmm. Are they using my eyes or there's another set of...
Oh, they got some other set of eyes. So I don't agree with the UFO thing because there is nothing in this universe that we are in that they do not know what's going on.
I just heard that they identified some planet that was similar to ours, that was close, similar to a star system like ours. And they said it was only, I think, about 10 light years away.
Okay.
Light years.
That's a different galaxy.
Well, no, what I'm saying is that I'm agreeing with you. If they can see that far,
thank you.
Maybe they can look in here and see.
Come on now.
Well, now, if we can do all of that, why do we still have people hungry? I mean, okay, tax money, they're using my money, your money, and other. Let's take a break. If I have some kind of controls over what they do with my tax money, I'll have a list of some of the things that we can talk about right on the other side of this break. And I would encourage other folk, if you've got some interests, some concerns, some things you'd like to talk about, some griefs that you'd like to prevent, give us a call, 909-792-5222. And I will take your call today, 909-792-5222. I'd like to hear what's on your mind about taxes, what's on your mind about other unidentified flying objects, because some of this tax conversation is certainly unidentifiable in terms of who the true beneficiaries are going to be. And before I go into the break one more time, I'd like to say, Andre Cole, man, we're going to be eating your food for a while. I don't know if I'm going to really have the little party and have people come over and eat it up, or if I'm just going to, because I was able to stack and put it in the refrigerator really good. And I am going to say, Andre's not a vegan, you know, so I... So I have to, kind of invite some non-vegan friends over to eat this stuff here. All right. And I got plenty of avocados, too. This is Empire Talks Back. I'm Wallace Allen, bragging about my avocados, bragging about how hard my wife is working through her knee replacement, doing a great job, bragging about her friend Andre Cole, who brought some great food over yesterday, and I'm bragging about Miss Tammy Martin Rouse. She's going to rile things up a little bit. She's going to show you how you could eat without meat and enjoy your holiday season. And of course, the Mood Master's in. You wouldn't know it by the lack of sound behind me right now, but he's here. He'll be beating up on that bass guitar when we get back. We do appreciate him and you. All right, we're going to take it away. We'll be back right after this break. 1, 2, 3.
Now I've got a love so deep in the pit of my heart, and each day.
Publish your legal notice in West Side Story newspaper. For the best service and the best rates, call 909-384-8131. Publishing legal notices in the city and county of San Bernardino since 1990. West Side Story provides friendly expert service. Call 909-384-8131 to benefit from budget-friendly rates. Whether a fictitious business name, a name change, a divorce summons, or any other legal or public notice, call West Side Story Newspaper, 909-384-8131. 909-384-8131. That's 909-384-8131.
Falling down the stairs and breaking your ankle doesn't sound good. But falling down the stairs and breaking your ankle with no health insurance sounds even worse. Life can change in an instant. Be covered when it does. At Covered California, we can help you get financial help to pay for your health plan. Covered California, it's more than just health care, it's life care. Visit coveredca.com today. Enroll by December 15th.
Okay, now. Yeah, let that play.
Now I've got a love so deep in the pit of my heart, and each day it grows.
Yeah, let it grow.
I'm
not ashamed to come and plead to you, baby.
Not ashamed to beg.
Walking out that door.
Now, I don't want her to walk out the door, but if I could get the president to walk out the door. Huh? Well, I'm saying it because I'm concerned about the fact that my president, your president, stood up last week and said, vote for Roy Moore, despite the fact that he, you know, he's a woman-hating lover and that he loves them to be under 21, under age 14, and grabbing them where the president said he endorses that, and he's endorsing slavery. The man said that the great days of America were during slavery. And the president of the United States agreed. Everybody that's laughing, you better understand something. Slavery included black folk, brown folk, yellow folk, white folk. Huh? You better look up when money gets to be the number one goal and rule, everything else falls aside. Folks, we stood up and watched our president of the United States last week endorse slavery. We've already heard him endorse sexual harassment, rape, anything that a celebrity rich man wants to do. And I guess, you know, that might include, I mean, if you're a rich white man or a rich black man or a rich green man, a yellow man, if you're rich, do what you want to do. Well, I'll tell you what, you got shot in the butt. That's what you need to have happen when you come around acting crazy, ignoring family values, ignoring the values that, come on, folks.
Well, can I ask you a question, Wallace? Now, I'm trying.
I don't know, Tammy. I'm still steaming over here. Maybe
you're steaming? Because this going to add to your steam.
Well, okay, maybe it'll warm things up. Maybe that's why we're having climate warming. Because people are getting so ticked off, they're just getting mad. Have you been walking around lately, folks, and just felt warm all of a sudden? It's not all menopause. It ain't all folks having them kind of hot flashes. Mm-hmm. This is concern for the planet. We're having this concern for the planet, and sometimes we don't even know it. This concept of UFOs, I was talking about UFOs.
Okay.
Now, some people say that these UFOs keep showing up whenever the United States or somebody else starts acting crazy about nuclear weapons and nuclear war. Now, are these UFO guys, and they say they're shaped like Tic Tacs. The ships are shaped like, I don't know if they're shaped like Tic Tacs and they're that small or they're that big, you know, but if Tic Tacs are good for your breath, maybe these things are good for our air. I don't know. All I'm saying is maybe they're coming here. If they could get here, if they were trying to harm us, it seems like they would have harmed us. I mean, if they could get here, they could do what they want. Maybe they're here to help. And then again, maybe, like you said, maybe this is our government scaring itself with its own little projects.
Yes. I think it's
point
their
that
way.
You made, though, is that we're strong enough, smart enough to do all of these things off the planet. Why do we keep letting such disorder take place on the planet? And when I say disorder, I'm talking about people that are hungry. Yeah. I'm talking about people that are displaced. I think those are real problems. Now, our economy is important, but the purpose of the economy is so it can take care of the people. I think. Maybe I'm wrong. 909-792-5222. Give us a call. Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe we should all be moving towards stingy. Maybe we should all be moving a little more toward mean and evil. You, Tammy, do you think maybe the food we eat may have something to do with mean and evil?
Well, I think
lack of food?
Well, I think it definitely does. As we have ventured into, you know, GMOs, genetically modified organisms.
Trying to
where
feed
we're
the planet. You know, we say we're trying to
the
feed
structure.
The planet, but then there's people all over the planet who are still hungry. But we're trying to have a mechanism or means of growing enough food to feed everybody.
Well, yeah, but people are not. I say it, you know, a lot of people come and talk to me about being woke. I say, well, what did you just put in your mouth? Do you read every label on there? Do you know what you, or do we just trust everybody of everything we put in our mouth. Because there are so many hormones there, and you talk about hormones.
Can we trust our society? Oh, can we trust people? Have you read your mortgage statement? Can you trust?
Okay.
Have you heard a commercial on TV where they're talking to you about your health, and they end up giving you 5,000 disclaimers and things to worry about?
Oh yeah.
You know that it's a
but 30 don't take while you drive, and then you might get killed while you, and then don't do it without this. You might die in dizziness, and then if you.
30-second commercial, 10 seconds tells you what the product is, 20 seconds tell you what you shouldn't do and what you should expect that it won't do and may do to you that ain't you that don't want to have done.
And I sit there and listen to that, I just start laughing.
Well, we get used to stuff, don't we?
Yeah, because if it's from nature, why would nature do that to you? So you know it has to be artificial, it has to be chemicals. So
I don't know. Now, let's say this. Now, nature doesn't say don't eat this kind of mushroom. You have to eat that kind of mushroom and die and then realize that, oh, that wasn't the kind of mushroom you eat. So nature has its little issues. Now, we have a reason to communicate with each other about nature. Mm-hmm. We have reasons to expect that, you know, nature is cool, but nature will get you.
Well, I have another conversation for that, because people say, yeah, you can't do this. But then we have to go back to what do we eat, the fruit and vegetables, and then what is alkaline? What is grown for us to eat? There's a lot of stuff that's growing just because people think it coming out of the ground, that it is our molecular structure. It's electricity that's attracted to us, and it's not. So we still have to be very careful.
Now, you are an educated person in this particular direction, and you teach school about the specifics of the body and what influences it, what makes it run right. So we have a reason to expect that you know what you're talking about.
Well, and what I don't know, I'm going to tell you, I'm doing research because things change every day. So I talk on what I know, what I've researched, and there's about 800 different studies out there to back me up.
Such as? When you say back you up, you know, back you
up
in what direction?
That why we should be, why we should not be eating starch vegetables, why we should not be eating animals, and all of this. If you look back and you think back, back in the 1900s, the beginning of the 1900s, we really only had about 10 diseases. Okay, since, now watch this. Now, since
10 diseases that we knew about or could name?
No,
or?
10, around 10 diseases. Now, as we got into fast food, as we got into GMOs.
Could we name those 10? I guess you could.
You know, your basic tuberculosis, you still had cancer, you had different things like that. But now we got all of these names. How many names you done seen pop up that you don't know what they are? You're sitting there like, where did that come from? Where did this come from? As we have, well, let me ask you a question, Wallace. Because since we're talking about the UFOs and we're talking about the taxes, tell me this. When you grew up in Mississippi, tell me how many fast food restaurants you went to. Come on, Wallace, talk to me.
I do have an aunt. Come on. My Aunt Peggy.
Okay, here we go.
Now, my Aunt Peggy is, she's, first of all of my grandmother, my mother's family, and father's family, they can all cook.
Yes.
I mean, some cook slow. Mm-hmm. And my Aunt Peggy,
okay.
Now she can make McDonald's be ashamed.
Okay.
In a variety of ways.
Okay.
First of all, the fare, the food fare, the food itself.
Yes.
Now she's not cooking a little hamburger. Mm-hmm. You know, I remember once going to see my Aunt Peggy, dropped in on her. She was expecting me, but I was unexpected at the time I went by. And Aunt Peggy, my mother's baby sister, about 15 minutes after I said hello, Aunt Peggy had a plate. I had some fried chicken. I had some lima beans. Had some yams. I had some stuff that some was already cooked. She just warmed, and then some stuff. But I mean, I can go into a fast food place and be there 15 minutes, and still not like what I get right there in the line. I love San Bernardino. I wish we had more restaurants.
Yes.
And the fact that the In-N-Out restaurant on 5th, right off the freeway, is probably the busiest restaurant in San Bernardino speaks volumes for a couple of things. One, it's a good restaurant, I guess. and In-N-Out is probably, you don't know this because you don't eat hamburgers, but if you were going to eat a hamburger, In-N-Out is probably the best hamburger to eat.
Well, they say, well, I mean, it's, I wouldn't deal with the beef itself, but the process of what you're talking about.
Yeah, the whole, mm-hmm. the whole, you know, and you know what? They'll actually make you one without the beef.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you can go in and say, I don't know exactly how to ask for it because I never.
With the lettuce and yeah. and the, all that other stuff, and but, you know.
But the fact that that is the. Probably, I don't know, I'm not going to say the most successful because I'm not counting people's money, but I'll tell you what, it's the only one that if I, well, no, we've got another couple of restaurants that people
I'm
have to
stand
in line for.
I'm still trying to figure out how many fast foods you went to.
When I was
how
in
many,
Mississippi,
did you know
not,
of?
Not
okay.
any.
Okay.
Not any. Miss Mabel's restaurant in Joliet was not
Which
best.
Ones you knew of that are out, that are going on now?
The only one that came into life was, and I guess, I don't know, I'm telling people how old I am, I guess, was McDonald's. Because that was really the first fast food place yeah. that anybody had was McDonald's.
And it started in San Bernardino.
Well,
but,
yeah. And I remember there's one on Joliet, in Joliet. And mm-hmm. I remember when it said we sold 100,000 burgers.
Yeah.
And then a million.
Now it's the. And billion and a trillion and stuff like that.
But, you know, it's a successful financial mm-hmm. model.
But you didn't eat any, did you?
I didn't eat any of that in Mississippi. Uh-huh. I didn't eat any of that. I don't think I had any fast food. And then again, this is saying
exactly.
how. I was here at the beginning of the history of fast food. Okay, mm-hmm. there that is. So, I mean,
I can say that when I grew up.
I can guarantee you that when my mother grew up,
uh-huh.
the only fast food was if Aunt Peggy got in the kitchen.
Mm-hmm.
And that was just faster food. It wasn't fast food.
Yeah, and it shows. It shows in research over and over again that when fast food started, see, that's when they had to preserve all that. That's when they had to put all of the chemicals in. You know, because you got food being shipped all around, then you got to keep it for long periods of time.
Let's take a break because some people are wanting to eat their breakfast. And they have not prepared themselves not to eat meat.
Yes.
And we want to give them a couple of minutes during the break to knock that bacon down
okay.
and do whatever they've got to do. And because the other truth is that if you exercise hard enough, it's almost doesn't matter what you eat. We'll be back right after this break and we'll argue that point too. And I still want to warn you that if you are a minority or a woman and you live in the United States, you may want to get politically active because the president has gotten politically active against you. And I shouldn't say you, I'm going to say us. Because slavery, minorities, black men, brown men, yellow men, green men, and yes, you purple men too, are in trouble here in the United States because you're not rich. President's got a hitman out there for you. It's either going to come in the form of taxes. It's going to come in the form of. Oh, we'll talk about it right after this break. We'll be right back.
Publish your legal notice in West Side Story newspaper. For the best service and the best rates, call 909-384-8131. Publishing legal notices in the city and county of San Bernardino since 1990. West Side Story provides friendly expert service. Call 909-384-8131 to benefit from budget-friendly rates. Whether a fictitious business name, a name change, a divorce summons, or any other legal or public notice, call West Side Story Newspaper, 909-384-8131. 909-384-8131. That's 909-384-8131.
At Covered California, we're not just here to help you get health insurance. We're here to help you get it at a lower cost. 9 out of 10 enrollees qualified for financial help paying for their plan. You may qualify for savings even if you didn't last year. So check for yourself. Or let our experts help you find out how much you could save. Life can change in an instant. Be covered when it does. Covered California. It's more than just healthcare. It's life care. Visit coveredca.com today. Enroll by December 15th.
Oh,
Oh, get it, Maurice. Woo, boy, I could play that all day. I guess that's what made the Earth, Wind, and Fire such a hot act. Man, those guys are good. Woo, Earth, Wind, and Fire. Add a little water and you really got something then. Earth, Wind, Fire, and water. Don't forget the Pisces. Please don't forget the Pisces and the Cancer and the Scorpio. We got to be there.
Yes.
We should be. Anyway, Earth, Wind, and Fire. Okay, we're back now, folks. I had to take a little break there, back to the good old days when things were predictable and I was young and dumb and hadn't learned as much as I know now and could dance all day. Now I wonder. We're speaking about reality. I spoke before the break about what's going on with our country, what's going on with our president, and you and our friends who are speaking with us. I brought up the fact that one of Mr. Trump's
communication
director, well, she hadn't been doing that great a job, obviously.
Mm. Been doing a good job and they just haven't been allowing her to communicate abroad.
Maybe there's that frustration.
Yeah.
But then again, I don't know how good she's getting paid. I understand she was one of the few people getting the full salary that the White House staff can afford.
$179,000 a year.
So she got at least a year's worth of checks here before her conscience hit her. Mm. Well, and we're talking about, what's her name, Amarosa?
Yes, Newman.
Amarosa Newman, she's the African-American lady who worked at the White House. She was also part of Trump's
reality show.
Assemblage of reality people, unreal and things of that sort. But that must have worked. I mean, I can't say anything about his TV show. It apparently is where he belonged. That was fine. But now that we've got to know, he has become the apprentice in the White House.
Well, yeah, some
people are like, what's going on? But you got to be rich. I don't know anybody poor. I don't know anybody who's middle class. I don't know anybody who's not a liar that's middle class and poor who says that they can get along with Trump. Hmm. I could be wrong. Call me. 909-792
5222.
Hey, I could be wrong, and I'm willing to say that I am. And you don't have to look like me. If you can explain to me what's good about Trump and explain to me and show to me how you're doing, have these good feelings, making less than $40,000 a year, I'll slap you in the mouth. No, I won't. I'm just kidding. I'm too old for that. So I wouldn't do that. No.
But you know, but it,
when I was 19, I might have though.
Yeah, but you know, it puzzles me when she went on Good Morning America and she said, "I've seen things that have made me uncomfortable, that have upset me, that have affected me deeply and emotionally, that has affected my community and my people. It is a profound story that I know the world would want to hear." Now I'm sitting here thinking, when she said that, when I read that, I'm like, where were you when he was on the trail for presidency and all of these things coming out? I'm like, where? See, that confuses me. Now I'm glad, as they say, people have seen the light. You know, sometimes
you're glad that they see the light, but you wonder
how
were they that blind before they got to the light?
Yes. And then she goes on to state, I mean, this is interesting to me. She said, "Yes, I will acknowledge many of the exchanges, particularly in the last 6 months. So have been racially charged," she added. Do we then just stop and label him as a racist? She says, no. Over the last 6 months. So my question is, what do you think happened in the last 6 months?
Think he might have found him another black girl? You think there's some jealousy involved here? We'll know. I don't know.
I don't know, but she says she has a lot to talk about.
Seems like he's only got room for one at a time.
I don't know, but she.
Oh, and I meant on his staff. I don't know what you guys were thinking. I meant on his staff. Now, he has already let it be known that he grab who he want to. But he don't let everybody work for him. So I'm just distinguishing the difference between who he determines grabbable and who he determines is, you know, people that he want to have close enough to grab all the time.
Yeah. I don't know.
Oh, you can't let that pass like that.
I know, I got
no, you. You can't let that pass like
or
that.
Or maybe she was touched.
That's what I said. I just suggested that the only women that the president's willing to keep around are the ones that are touchable.
Yeah.
Now, somebody ought to be mad at that. Somebody ought to call me and say, Wallace, that's kind of low. But you can't say that. Mm-hmm. You can't say that because the man has already said that's what women are for. That's what women are. Come on now. And then he stands up and he endorses Roy Moore after.
Uh-oh.
Wait a minute. After. Uh-oh. He didn't endorse Roy Moore before Roy Moore let the world know that he thought slavery was when America was great. After Roy Moore said what he said about slavery. Next thing I know, 2 days later, we got the president endorsing him. We got to have him. We need. Come on, folks. We got to wake up. I think that we've woken the UFO people. They've come down to check it out.
Well, that's what they
said. Or they've come out to check it out, because a lot of people say, "Now, you know, I'm not a conspiracy theorist, but I am a listener. I do like stories. Matter of fact, the more far out the story, the more likable it is to me, because that means it's probably further away from a hidden lie.
Mm-hmm.
I don't mind hearing a lie if it's an entertaining lie and it's an obvious lie and it becomes a story.
Yeah.
But a conniving lie is different. So I'm concerned that maybe there's something going on that we should know about, that we don't know about, but that we're feeling about it, and I'm here to follow my feelings. I get the impression, I heard Kanye say a couple of years ago about Bush don't like black people. I don't know where Kanye is, but he needs to step up, because I think Trump doesn't like any people. He doesn't like poor people. He doesn't like people who...
I think he does like poor people. But let's not get it confused.
Did you read the little thing, the little PC, the rumor about how he feels about Vice President Pence?
Mm-hmm.
He's just too poor. He's just a...
No, because Pence got his own mouth. But...
that could be.
Yes. But no, I think he does...
Even if it's a poor mouth. It's okay.
He compartmentalizes. He likes things the way... You know, in a compartment. Of course, he likes poor people. He likes poor people because he likes them there, and then he likes people over here because it's all a design, and that this is how wealth is developed.
You had some people ask some questions to us about Omarosa.
Well, this is the article that I'm reading, and I've been reading it over and over again because I have to study the article, because they talk about how she abruptly, I mean, she left in a hurry. It wasn't right after she was watching a news interview. I mean, watching television, she left. So he didn't even know she was leaving.
Did she quit or was she fired?
I think she left. They want to turn it into a firing.
Well, now, if she left, she would have been able to leave that day the same way she left the day before, and that would have been alone with her bags and just walked out the door. She was escorted out.
Of course, because she had keys and she knew some information. So, you know, they ain't going to let you go in and out the door. Wallace, come on. Let you have somebody in your house.
Wait a minute. So we don't know exactly if she said, all right, I quit and here are my keys and you leave. Or do you leave and send the keys back and say, oh, I won't be back? I think she's a smart enough lady that she has probably seen enough to know from The Apprentice even that, you know, if I get fired, that's one thing. But if I'm not fired, I want to handle this thing myself and I'll quit. But would I quit and make a scene? And get walked out the door, make it look like, hey, we caught you stealing paper clips and that's just one paper clip too many. I don't know. I don't know the full story of her. I do say this, that I kind of lost a lot of interest in her after she stayed in the realm of Trump after he ran for president. I can't say exactly when. And there's probably something he could do tomorrow that would, you know, that I could say is good. I'm able to compartmentalize also. He's not a good president, but even a broken clock is right twice a day. So he's not a good president, but he can accidentally get some things done. Mm-hmm. And I think people may have backed off their accelerator of hate, accelerator of investigation, because mm-hmm. they've seen him, you know, put on the brakes in time to not run over something that they thought was important. Folks, we've got to keep our eyes open. We've got a health plan that's going to make many people angry. Fathers who cannot take care of their children get upset. Mm-hmm. Fathers who have sick children and a route to wellness that is simply blocked by belligerence and arrogance and hate. These people turn into something. You know, we can go train people to go to Afghanistan and show them how to shoot 600-700 yards accurately and this, that, and the other, and then bring them home, treat them like kubliwak, and expect that they're not going to do something? We're making our own terrorists, folks, creating our own terrorists, because we are terrorizing folks about their general ability to live and be productive in this the richest country on the planet. We need to change this attitude. We need to change those people who are in charge of the attitude. We need to take advantage of the fact that we can vote, that we do have some influence, and that the UFOs are not the only ones that see what the heck is going on around here that isn't right. Mm-hmm. We're going to take this last break. We'll be back right afterwards, and we're going to keep on moving towards some solutions and some ideas. We're not quitting. We're not going to jump off the cliff. We're not getting ready to cut our wrists. We're not getting ready to stop eating. We may change what we're eating, like Miss Tammy keeps suggesting. Maybe your brain is being clouded by that grease. Other people have said it. I'm just saying it. I don't know. You know, I eat a little grease myself. A lot of people tell me I'm crazy as hell. We'll be back right after this break.
Wonder if she's gone to stay.
Publish your legal notice in West Side Story newspaper. For the best service and the best rates, call 909-384-8131. Publishing legal notices in the city and county of San Bernardino since 1990. West Side Story provides friendly expert service. Call 909-384-8131 to benefit from budget-friendly rates. Whether a fictitious business name, a name change, a divorce summons, or any other legal or public notice, call West Side Story Newspaper, 909-384-8131. 909-384-8131. That's 909-384-8131.
I'm young, active, and in the best shape of my life. But I still know life can change in an instant, and when it does, I want to be prepared. That's why I have a healthcare plan through Covered California, to cover life's unexpected moments. And having a plan that includes preventive care just makes sense. That means I don't pay extra for services like annual checkups, flu shots, and diabetes screenings. I like that.
Covered California. It's more than just healthcare. It's life care. Visit coveredca.com to enroll or find free expert help. Enroll by December 15th.
Wonder this time where she's gone. Wonder if she's gone.
Did she go away? Is she gone? Is she really there? That's the same thing with the UFO. Unidentified flying objects. If we had unidentified flying objects, that would make a lie out of all of the great telescopes we've got out there. It would make a lie out of the military, the United States military, Russia, the Israelis, I mean, South Africa. These guys have some pretty powerful means of seeing what's going on. And if it's an asteroid, I mean, we've seen the movie. If it's an asteroid and it's coming toward the Earth, everybody's coming together. The Russians, United States, the Israeli, and the Palestinians. Everybody's coming together to save the world when they... But here we are with some unidentified flying objects. Mm-hmm. Tammy, what have you heard? What would you think that a government could take advantage of by confusing or scaring people or not, or pretending that they're not scaring you? In other words, all of this stuff about UFOs, don't worry about that. That's not true. And yeah, we check on them, but we ain't really worried about them. But they are really fast and they are mysterious and... Ooh-wee. Now, what can you do with that?
Well, See, I have to go back to all the intelligence that we have working for us, and we're supposed to be the smartest country. And
according to us.
Mm-hmm. And
thank you, Anthony.
And no one was in our parameter. That's just like asking the people, the air traffic controllers, what do you see in the air? They know what's in the air, just like our government knows what is in our air. So I feel that, and just reading a couple of articles, they were talking about a program that everybody thought had shut down in 2012 that governs a lot of this stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Is even though the funding went out, the program is still in existence. So there are so many ways that they come out and do things. Just like I told you, they don't tell you about what's in your food and how it's killing you. They're not going to tell you what's out there, because then they need to start asking you for permission to get all into your life. Now, why would I ask you for permission?
Well, point in hand, the stealth airplane that we have,
mm-hmm.
that is able to reflect light in a way that makes it look actually invisible,
mm-hmm.
was in possession and use of our military,
yeah.
25 years before we as individual public people knew about
See?
It. So the development of, there are people in our government who probably haven't told Mr. Trump
mm-hmm.
some of the important things, because they see how cootie-wootie he is. And I don't know that for sure. I don't want you guys coming by picking me up in the middle of the night thinking that I know something. I'm guessing.
Okay.
Wallace has not pulled up any Pentagon papers or special space, whatever you guys have been hiding from us. But I can say this. Whatever you're hiding, whatever is being hidden, it still is not as important as we people getting along.
Yeah.
Because if we get along, almost anything that is brought to us can be dealt with. And I think that's why we have people who keep trying to split us up. We have circumstances that keep trying to divide people instead of pulling people together. I want to thank you, Tammy, for last week. You brought a special guest into us. You brought Mr. Frank
Montez
in, mm-hmm. who represents and is the president of this
Chair of the California Hispanic Chamber of Commerce.
Right. And the fact that the Hispanic Chamber and our Black Chambers are working together,
yes.
is I think speaks just, it's a wonderful thing. To what extent, now there are other chambers, diverse chambers, the Korean Chamber, Asian Chambers.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
One of the things that one of my friends asked me across the week was, why do we have all these different chambers? Why isn't there just one? Isn't there just one attitude that helps the businesses? And I have to keep saying, well, maybe so, but we do have different communities, and our different communities represent diversity and cultural aspects that are really, I think, mm-hmm. too valuable to be thrown away or melted away into a melting pot.
Mm-hmm.
I like my family.
Yeah.
I like being close to my grandkids. I want to be in a community where their needs are met so that they can live in the same area where Papa and Grandma live.
Mm-hmm.
I understand why people want to be culturally close to each other. Doesn't say that they don't want to be with someone else.
Mm.
So all of that to say, congratulations to you. Congratulations to the other chamber. Congratulations to everybody who sees a need to function mm. together.
Wait, can I say something on that?
You have to.
Okay. When people ask me all the time, you know, why, and of course I get it from all across, from African Americans, everyone, even, you know, Caucasians, everyone. And I tell them, let's look at data.
So the question they're asking
yes.
you is,
when why is there a Black chamber? And I said, well, let's look at data, because data doesn't lie. And I said, when you look at data and you step into an environment and the data is not addressed as to we're all sitting together, and if we're all sitting together and racially the data is divided, meaning that you can look up and you see the amount of business loans, the amount of benefits, the all of them where, you know, African Americans are at the bottom, there's something wrong with this graph. And I say it, and until that graph becomes even,
the statistics that are very real,
soon as it becomes even, then we don't have a need for a Black chamber or an Asian chamber, but they're proportionally different. And why is that? And why aren't they being addressed in the so-called, we don't have a chamber with color? Well, no, the Black chamber doesn't have color. The Black chamber just addresses a lot of the statistics that are associated with the reports out there when it comes to, all you got to do is log in on the census. Just look at the census and how many businesses, and then go from there. And then they're going to say, well, why is that number? So why is it not brought up at our
major chamber meetings?
Exactly.
That's the same situation that has made it necessary to have a Black Elks, Black American Legion.
Preach.
And it goes back again to statistics. When we look at our statistics, our vitals.
I'm going to use Omarosa's quote.
Mm-hmm.
It's racial, but it's not racist.
And Mr. Anthony said, well, if it's racial, how can it not be racist? Racial, let me say this, and I'll show you that it can be. The Black chamber is racial because there are issues of race that need to be addressed that the regular majority, and I should say white chamber because that's basically what it is.
Okay, you said it because I
does not
say it.
Address.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe they say that, well, maybe we have some target committees to work with that. The problem isn't a committee problem. It's a real problem.
Yes.
The problem of why African-American kids get kicked out of school earlier, end up with referrals that make it impossible for them to get jobs later on. They end up going to the referrals from school. You're a school teacher. You asked me about when I was a child, what kind of fast foods I ate. Ask me about what happened as a child when we got in fights at school.
Yeah.
We just got in fights. And the principals, and sometimes depends on where you were or how old you were, they might put you some boxing gloves on and send you into a room and let you box it out. Now you get in a fight, you get referred to the police.
Exactly.
And that, I mean, in fourth grade, a referral to the police? And of course,
I haven't seen too many of those, but I mean,
but if you saw one, that's too many. And yeah. I can bring you some because that's one of the issues that we have about the referrals.
Well, I know with the illegal activity, if they bring something illegal to school, that's a little bit that's a little bit cray cray.
The vitals are important. African Americans, you tell me about who goes to jail, you know, and I'll go back and talk to you about, well, when jails were first put together in the United States.
Oh,
remember, they were for runaways, slave runaways. They were not for anybody else.
And that movie came out, talked about that. What's the 24, what is 13? Lord, the number.
Point is, folks, we can do better, and there are ways to do better, and reaching out and speaking to each other makes it better. I do appreciate better. I know that it's possible. My wife is getting better because she's working on it. Andre's a better cook because he's working on it.
Mm-hmm.
Boy, Andre, I really appreciate that food you brought over. And Anthony's a better bass player because he practices. Folks will be better citizens because we reach out and talk to each other and listen to each other, and because we want it to be better. UFOs are not the only folks that can identify the fact that we have a problem here and that we can solve it. And we're going to solve it. It's the perfect time of the year. This is the season that everybody's saying happy hello, and this, that, and the other. We got Hanukkah, we got Christmas, religious holidays, and we've got the big cultural Kwanzaa Day. Folks, there's no reason for you not to feel good. And if you see some people who are not doing good, come up out of your pocket. Do something for them. Invite them for dinner. Go buy them something. Give them a number that you'll be willing to use, let them use a month from now, not just during the holiday, so that you can demonstrate some help. We're going to be here next week under two circumstances. One, if the good Lord's willing, Two, if the creek don't rise. And that leaves us time for a lot of good things to happen. Tammy, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Guys, take care out there. Be good to somebody. You know how to do it. Treat them the way you want to be treated.
Hello.
We'll see you then. Bye.
I know we've got a long way to go. Where we'll end up, I don't.
KCAA Loma Linda, 1050 AM, 106.5 FM, and now 102.3 FM.
Your NBC Sports Radio update starts now.
Checking the scoreboard in the NFL right now. The Vikings are cruising at home against the Cincinnati Bengals. They seem to be playing a little bit distracted with all the news about Marvin Lewis perhaps stepping down at the end of the season. It's the Vikings 17 and the Bengals nothing. 11 minutes to go in the first half in that game. Other scores, the Redskins are leading the Arizona Cardinals 14-3 midway through the second quarter. Kirk Cousins has a touchdown.